Well, the New York Mets make another offseason move, signing a new player. And while he's not one of the big names many fans have been wishing for, he could make a big difference in Flushing in the lineup. And Steve Overmyer joins us now with more. Steve, this is, I guess it's interesting that the Mets just keep making the moves, right?
They keep making moves, still waiting on the big splash, but this is a move that gets the Mets going in the right direction. It certainly fills an area of need. Jed Lowrie is an infielder who has played for 11 years in the majors. Last year, he actually enjoyed career highs in home runs and RBI. He's being brought in to play every day, but in multiple positions. He says he chose the Mets because the new general manager and his former agent, Brody Van Wagenen, actually was very aggressive. And after the press conference, Van Wagenen was asked why he didn't target bigger names like Manny Machado and Bryce Harper.
I think anything is possible, but we have to be realistic about the team that we've built so far. And, you know, there aren't very many players on the position player side that fit our team the way that we've currently constructed it. We have, as we just talked about, we have depth and versatility in the infield, particularly on the left side of the infield with Rosario and Lowry and Frazier. You know, Machado plays on the left side of the infield. We have depth in the outfield, especially on the corners with McNeil and Conforto and Nimmo, and now we've added some defensive support in center field with Broxton. So, you know, I think we have to look at our roster based on our needs, our fits, our resources, and not be concerned about what the market is. You know, you'll hear from me as a former agent that I hope we're creating our own market based on what our needs are, and I hope everybody else does the same, but we're not going to be concerned about what other people are doing.
All right, you get what he's trying to say. You want to build a team that's got depth because that's certainly been an issue for the Mets in the past few years. You want guys that can play multiple positions, but if you have an opportunity, now you have some of the best pitchers in baseball are cost-effective, you actually have the money to go out and spend to get some hitters, and those guys are on the market, it seems like it would be something they'd be at least interested in.
Those guys include Bryce Harper, you know, one of the greats right now. A cynical Mets fan, and there are many who would say, this really sounds like the Will Pons all over again. Right. Why would we go for the big guy? Because they do great things. Bryce Harper is a great left-handed hitter.
Yeah, and he's only 26 years old. He's 26. He's been in the majors for 7 years, and six of those 7 years, he's been an all-star. He won an MVP. He's got great batting average, on-base percentage, OPS is through the roof. This is the kind of guy, the kind of clutch player that will make every team
every
a championship
team.
Contender. There's no doubt about it. And it's going to cost, though. It's $30 million a year. Now, in contact with a couple of agents, they made it sound like Bryce Harper right now will likely go back to the Nationals because the Nationals have made a 10-year, $300 million deal. And the belief, at least among the agents, is that Harper is trying to leverage other teams' better offers to try to get more money out of the Nationals. But ultimately, he is going to end up with the Nationals.
All right, let's have another conspiracy theory. I know you're good at ones like the Kennedy assassination, but we're going to stick with baseball for now because there's another conspiracy theory we're hearing now, and it's going to include Manny Machado because this is another superstar who's not getting the offers you might expect. So is something going on there? We know Manny, he said the stupid thing about I'm not a hustling kind of guy, but nonetheless it just seems that these two guys who are super duper stars and as you point out in their 20s would be getting much bigger offers.
Sure.
A little suspicious here.
So a report came out today that the White Sox had offered Manny Machado somewhere around $175 million, which is ridiculously low considering amazing. 175 is low.
Yeah, right, exactly.
Agent came out and said that is untrue, that the offers for Manny are going to be much bigger. Here's the thing. We are in a point of the season as we are, 5 weeks away from spring training. When Harper and Machado sign, that's when the rest of the field will sign. So everybody's waiting for these two players to pick their teams, and the teams are almost feeling like they're waiting until the last minute so that they can drive the market down as low as possible and get a deal for one of these big guys.
But there also is that thing about, you know, in terms of not giving them the big salaries, it's almost become like a salary cap in baseball because of the so-called charge for the luxury tax charge.
That's right. There's a luxury tax.
It's almost become like a salary tax.
Yeah, absolutely. And when you talk about the Mets' needs, you know, they just added Lowry, who is a third baseman, and so is Todd Frazier, who's a third baseman as well. So one of those guys are going to have to play first base. If you bring in a Manny Machado, where do you put a Manny Machado?
10 seconds or less. Who goes in center field? What are you going to do?
I think it could be A.J. Pollock. That would be the big name that the Mets would be targeting. But right now, they've got four outfielders, maybe five when Cespedes comes back. It might be just one of the guys they have on the roster right now.
Did you say when Cespedes comes back?
August. It's supposed to be August.
All right, we don't have enough time for it. Next time.
We'll see.
Okay. Great job as always, Steve.